We like you too.
Makes you get to know me.
What's up, boys and girls? We just watched the trailer for Don't Worry,
He Won't Get Far on Foot.
Starring Joaquin Phoenix,
Jonah Hill,
Rooney Mara,
Jack Black.
And directed by that guy.
Gus Van Sant, who also did Milk and Good Will Hunting, and a few other movies that people know about.
That guy. And it looks more like my type of film.
Oh!
We just did a preview for the other Joaquin Phoenix movie.
That is more my type of film, Thriller.
Yes, you
were never really,
never really there. Forgot the name of that film. But this one looks like kind of like a heart tugger.
It's when I posted it on Instagram, I said good humor for the soul. Mm-hmm. It seems like it is humorous, but it also seems like it hits you hard with the humor. Something that you need to hear, but it's heartwarming.
Yeah, I don't think it's not one of those where it's like spoon-fed to you.
No.
I don't think it's going to be those things, but I think it's something that'll make you think. And it'll make you think about your own life. It'll make you think about, you know, other people's lives and just the value of life.
I mean,
this movie looks like Joaquin Phoenix drank for a long time, got a bad car accident, he became a paraplegic, is that what it's called?
I think so.
Paraplegic, and it looks like he's found friends with Jack Black, he's found friends with Jonah Hill's character.
Got a love interest in Rooney Mara, which is like, that's a win-win regardless, so if I can't move, I want her on top of me.
Exactly.
That's simple.
The third thing I was thinking. Looks like it was based on a true story, so that's an interesting thing. Yeah. But I feel like Joaquin Phoenix, he's already coming out with a movie in April, right?
April.
And he's coming out with this one in May. Both Amazon Studios,
right.
I think he's making a big comeback. And I think he is definitely showing his range with
these
two vastly different movies. And I think with this one, this is a star-studded cast. And I think with that, it is just going to make this film overall just really strong and over the top.
I'm excited to see it, regardless if it is a movie, you know, a theme that, you know, I don't automatically shift to. Joaquin Phoenix, in the last 5-6 years, has been one of my favorite actors. I mean, Her in 2013. You got The Master the year before that. I can't even remember all the other movies he's done before then, but just from like 2011, 2012 till now, this guy's been knocking it out of the park. Inherent Vice, hilarious, oddball comedy, detective kind of story. And these latest two films, now with this one, this seems like it's a great contrast to You Were Never Really Here. Mm-hmm. Don't Worry, You Won't Get Far on Foot seems like it is more of a feel-good movie, even if it hurts to look at some of the things and the themes that it plays with. I'm definitely excited to see this film.
I'm excited to see this film as well. I'm always good about crying during the last third act. Although there's not multiple third acts, I just meant the third act, I guess.
That was the third act of the film. He's gonna cry.
I'm gonna cry. So what do you guys think of the film? Or sorry, what do you guys think of the trailer? You guys have any comments? What do you think about Joaquin's return?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he's kind of left the limelight, but he seems like he's coming back strong. He likes just working with the independent studios, Amazon Studios.
Right.
He likes working on these independent films more than he likes working on the big budget Hollywood films.
Like Gladiator. Mm-hmm. It seems like he likes working with film auteurs, people that have a lot of good films in their canon, who have visions, they stick with them and they bring them to fruition. It's not driven by money, it's driven by the vision. So I think this is gonna be no different. Both of these movies are gonna be phenomenal this year. I think Don't Worry, He Won't Get Far on Foot. I don't think it's gonna be huge at the box office. I don't think a lot of people are gonna see it, but I think through word of mouth and through streaming and Amazon, I think a lot of people are then going to recognize it like they did The Big Sick, where they start to recognize it and they realize, oh, this is a movie that has some serious tones, but it's actually pretty damn funny, and it's just good at heart. I think it's gonna be a similar story to that.
And at the end of the day, those are the type of movies we like. So if you liked this trailer view, give us a thumbs up. Give us a subscribe. We also have a Instagram, which I just remembered right now.
Oh yeah.
It's at Black and Yellow Movies. And we have movie facts.
Yep.
We have news. And we have our very short reviews that link to longer reviews.
Oh, review.
Well, this is Black and Yellow Movies, and we'll see you guys next time.
Red like Reynolds aluminum wrap?
Red Nose. I remember the British people are like, they're eating
it.
Because you have Michael Caine. I failed you.
And like Gary Oldman when he's playing like Winston Churchill. Oh, yes.
Master Bruce. Master Bruce.